I think that that's something that Battlefield really hasn't been done in a very long time. So I'm looking forward to it.
Miranda, Elden Ring. We have to keep the audience happy by bringing up Elden Ring because it is probably the most anticipated game that's not a first party exclusive somewhere. We got to at Jeff Keighley's Summer Game Fest. Do you think we get an extended gameplay demo here on Microsoft stage?
You know, that would be really cool. I don't think.
All right. So if everyone can hear me, please type in chat real quick. Just want to make sure everything's working.
There's so much to dig into there, but.
All right, can you guys all hear me?
For gameplay, it's just too far. Asking for an extended trailer would be nice, but I don't believe it's going to happen based on how they've been talking about it or lack of talking about it or showing it in any way.
Awesome. Can you guys hear me in chat?
Destin, do you share Miranda's pessimism on this or do you think today is the day since it did?
Okay, awesome. Awesome. Good to see.
Yeah, you know,
all right, so I'm thinking of just watching the IGN stream for now. Let me know if I'm too loud or the video's too loud. Just let me know.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised at all if we saw more of it because they had their big reveal on Keighley's thing. They're just not going to have another beat during E3. I mean, Xbox is the stage where it makes the most sense to talk more about this game.
Now, we've also had confirmation this morning that we're going to see more Far Cry 6. Ubisoft tweeting that out this morning. So expect to see that on stage here today at the Xbox.
So real quick, I'm going to switch and see if I can find the Xbox stream. Okay, this one. Oh, we still got to wait such a long time, but we'll see. Alright, so less than 5 minutes to go. Do y'all think we're gonna see Forza Horizon? Turn the E3 stream up. I got you. One sec. Let me know if that is better. Yeah, probably, hopefully, yeah. I mean, I really hope we see it. You never know with Microsoft, right? They kind of are just, you never really know what they might do, so guess we shall find out. What's up, Addy Gaming? Good to have everyone here in the stream. Yeah, so this is my first ever stream, so please let me know if I'm too loud, anything else is too loud, just let me know. What's up, Carbon07? Good to have you here in the stream. Everything is good. All right, good to hear that. Man, 3 minutes to go. Let me make sure I'm at, Oh, we can only go 1080p? Oh, come on, man. Yeah, well, I guess we'll, not long to wait anyways. 1080p should be fine. Alright, thanks Stuart. Let me know it sounds great. Good to hear. That all is awesome. Can't watch from Xbox's channel because the age restriction. Aw, that sucks. Like Halo might be, yeah, I think Halo's definitely going to come up. I think we probably will not end up getting a release date too, so yeah, I guess we'll just have to wait and see. Less than a minute and a half to go. Alright, just messing with a few settings on stream here. Okay, 1 minute to go. Let me know if you guys can hear any background noise. My neighbors might have their dogs in the yard or anything, so if you hear anything, then, you know, that'll be it. Seconds. Damn. All right, guys, countdown. Here it is. Oh, let's go. Hey ZiniBoy45, welcome to the stream. We got a lot coming up. Stream's just starting now, and yeah, let's see what Xbox has to show off. Love the small community. Yeah, me too, dude. It's not huge, but I love everyone that's here. It's really awesome to see how everything goes.
20 years.
Oh,
that's how long Xbox has been with us. And like you, this is a moment I always look forward to. I love seeing the new games, crossing my fingers for my favorites to return, hoping for a few surprises. Most of all, though, I love seeing everyone around the world come together and celebrate what games mean to all of us. And I think, you know, this past year, they've meant even more. Thank you for being with us today. Thank you for the support you give us and one another. Xbox is turning 20. And I wouldn't be here if it wasn't for the friendships we've had that whole time. At Bethesda, we believe video games do one thing better than anything else. They transport us.
Yeah, I mean, TDO doesn't really have anything to do with Xbox, so I don't think it'll be shown on this stream. And they did say the next time they'd show anything about it would be in July, so we're not going to see anything here about TDO, but yeah, I mean, we got to wait about a month.
We're creating a new universe with Starfield. Set hundreds of years in our future.
Okay, Starfield, let's go.
It's an epic about hope, our shared humanity, and answering our greatest mystery. It's a game we've dreamt of playing. And it wasn't until now that we have the hardware, the technology, and the team who's hard at work at home to make that dream a reality. We're excited to finally share our first in-game teaser and something to look forward to.
Okay, let's see what's going on with Starfield.
They say, the wonder is, not that the field of stars is so vast, but that we have measured it. You're part of Constellation now. Part of our family. What you've found, it's the key to unlocking everything.
We reach your constellation.
The working towards. We've come to the beginning of humanity's final journey.
Prepare for departure. Graviton loop array full check. Your space lane is clear.
That's why we're here.
Main engines go. Ignition.
To discover what's out there.
Good luck, Constellation. You are go.
Can we see some actual gameplay, though? Is that it? Okay, so it's only exclusive to next gen gaming and Xbox Cloud Gaming. Okay. Xbox exclusive. Okay, so it will not be on PlayStation as we originally thought. Wow. That's crazy.
It is awesome to share with you for the very first time one of the most anticipated games in the world from Todd Howard and the team at Bethesda Game Studios. A groundbreaking game. And yes, it's exclusive. Welcome to the Xbox and Bethesda Game Showcase. I am so excited and proud to be here today celebrating games, because although it's been an incredibly tough year, I am grateful that games have been such an important source of joy and connection. We are committed to forging the next era of gaming.
Xbox is starting to be PS5 with exclusivity. Not yet.
All devices,
I mean, neither console has any really good exclusives
everyone.
Just yet, so let's just wait and see. I mean, they're both not great right now.
Not just as partners, but as one team, united in bringing the very best games to more people everywhere. So today, we get to reveal more of what's to come. We have an amazing show, 30 titles, 27 in Xbox Game Pass. And of course, every single console title you'll see today is optimized for Xbox Series X and S, offering next-gen performance, speed, and features. We get to work with the best studios on Earth. Next is something truly riveting, the latest entry in the haunting and evocative franchise created by GSC Game World, Stalker 2.
Stalker 2,
coming
okay.
First to Xbox Series consoles and PC. This will be a true next-gen experience, targeting 4K resolution and ray tracing. Let's take a look at what you'll get to play when it launches next year.
Okay, let's see some Stalker 2 gameplay. I'm really excited to see what they do with this one. Console launch exclusive. Okay, so it'll probably release on PlayStation, just not yet.
Ну, чё там?
Готово.
Ну и пошли они нахрен.
Спасибо тебе. Ты многим...
Ukraine simulator, let's go.
Ну, давай, малюй картину маслом.
Lighting looks incredible, actually. This is good. Yo, there's a guy on your left, bro. Who's playing?
Вот поэтому я ни в какие разборки и не лезу. Не хочу пулю поймать.
Ну не знаю. Между аномалией и маслиной.
Ooh, I really like the art style of this game. Yeah, the reflections look insane. Whoa. Okay, looks like we could have some really unique gameplay elements in this one. This game looks lit. Yeah, this one looks incredible.
Вот ты говоришь, а я прям вижу красоту эту. Не первый год в зоне, вроде примелькалась уже, а каждый день удивляет.
Зона надоесть не может.
The sounds, though, yeah. This game is gonna be really immersive.
Говорят, ты знаешь, где вход в фундамент.
Yeah, even the ground, it looks so good. Okay, my boy got the moves. Okay.
Слышал? Вот это культура. А ты одно и то же по кругу лобаешь.
Сам же просишь. У меня музучилище, если что.
О, месье. Прошу прощения. Может, вам к ученым? Профессура. Они вам лабораторию найдут.
Okay, this looks really good. Oh. So this game could possibly have like a horror element to it. Nice. I'm really excited to see what'll happen with this one.
Ты так с друзьями. Ты же его на вылазки таскаешь.
Чего чего? А дружбы в зоне.
Yeah, Syndicate, this game looks really like high quality.
Это верно.
Он мучился?
Нет.
Это хорошо. Он этого не заслужил.
А пулю заслужил. Жаль, что ты так с ним поступил.
Мне тоже. Считаешь, я не думал, как обойтись без его смерти? Она не могла быть свободна, пока он жил. Зато теперь посмотри на нее. Нет, Скиф, я не отдам ее никому. Зона дала мне жизнь, новую жизнь. Жизнь, которую я готов вернуть, если потребуется. Я буду защищать ее. Всегда.
Hope they can have it in VR. Yeah, if this game is in VR, that would be incredible. I mean, look at that, look at that. Look at the like electricity effects. My god. Looks kind of like the new Dying Light. Yeah, I mean a little bit.
Похоже, пора.
That like post-apocalyptic setting.
В Припять. Нужно с ним поговорить.
Удачной охоты, сталкер.
Oh, can we get a release date, please? Part of Chernobyl. Okay. Release date? Okay. 28th of April, 2022. Okay. That one looks really good. I'm really excited to play that one. What's this? Oh. Warner Brothers? What's this?
We're surviving here.
Oh, this is Back for Blood, right? The spiritual Left 4 Dead successor.
No, we don't need to do anything. All right, when was the last time you saw written in any numbers?
I've played a lot of Left 4 Dead too, so I'm excited to see, you know, what they do with this game.
No rest for the wicked.
Let's go.
You're here. Come on. God, I love Mondays.
This fall. Okay. All right. So it's not too far away. It almost looks like Walking Dead. Yeah. I mean, it's got a lot of those same vibes. Yeah, old games are coming back this year. Yeah, I mean, that's been a trend recently, right? It's bringing back old franchises. Okay, new game modes, that's cool.
Buckle up, buttercups.
We've got one shot. Let's make it count.
Yeah, definitely looks interesting. Oh, dude, do you see that thing? October 12th, okay. Oh, and it'll be on Xbox One, too, so you can play it on last gen, okay. Also on Game Pass. Xbox Game Studios presents console exclusives, okay. Game Studios, Avalanche Studios, I forget, oh, they make Just Cause, okay, but what game is this? Forza Horizon 1960, yes. That's the same box from the picture, but what is this box? Contraband? Okay. I mean, it's not really much to go off of there, but it could be interesting. Just a CGI trailer. I mean, you know, not much to go off of, but interesting concept, I guess. I'll not see a thieves, man. Yeah, waiting for that Made for Playground games to show up. Absolutely.
An eel wind blows from beyond the horizon. A new danger is coming on the tides. And the one who might stop this ruin, trapped for all forever in the
it's like
Sea
of the Thieves
Damned.
DLC or something?
Now, to save the pirate life, you must start by saving the life of one.
Oh! Didn't realize we had company. Captain Jack Sparrow. But I suspect you already knew
Jack Sparrow
that.
DLC for Sea of Thieves. Disney expansion?
Because of the treasure Jack stole, a darkness followed him here. And if it's not stopped, this world will sink into shadow.
This sea holds many secrets.
You know, I haven't played Sea of Thieves since it first came out, but I've heard it's improved a lot since the game first released.
The so-called Sea of Thieves.
Almost cartoonish? Yeah, Sea of Thieves has always been that way. It's very cartoonish.
A legion of dead, angry pirates. Oh, yes. And now, one Davy Jones. Hello! Well, I believe that now is the perfect time to use these cannons.
Getting Disney Infinity vibes, yeah, for sure. Okay, it looks like new animal types. That's interesting, at least. Oh, what is that?
Destroy them! I don't suppose, by chance, there's a second one of those? The Sea of Thieves, eh? Bring me that horizon.
I mean, this could be cool. I mean, for the people who enjoy Sea of Thieves, I mean, it could be good. June 22nd. And at least it's coming out, like, in a week or two, right? So, for people who like Sea of Thieves, that's awesome. Yakuza? Okay. I actually, if I'm totally honest, I've never played the Yakuza games. But I've heard they're really good.
Hey, how's it going?
Let's do this. Free Sinope DLC, that's good. Everything. If a Yakuza shows weakness, he's done. Time to call a friend.
Order. What the?
Happy birthday.
The only Yakuza games you played with 1 to 4. Yeah, what are the best ones? Because I want to try them out. I just don't know where to start.
Incoming fire!
Is this Battlefield or what is this? Oh yeah, it's Battlefield 2042. Okay. You know, I'm excited for this game, but I don't like that there's no single player. That's my main problem with this game. I'm sure it's going to be a ton of fun, multiplayer, but... yeah, no single player definitely sucks. The game looks incredible, though, not going to lie. Okay, you got, like, grappling hooks. Hey, Salties, no problem being late, it's all good. Yeah, this is Battlefield. Okay, the tanks are being dropped in, alright. I'm just happy we're seeing gameplay for now. If these buildings are destructible, then I am 100% getting this game. Like, on launch, I'm gonna hop on the multiplayer and just... oh, that's a cool little inventory system. Okay, you got, like, dynamic weather and stuff. This looks really good. Yeah, just chuck the ATV in there. Okay, you got zip lines and all that. Dude, with 128 players, this game is going to be just insane. Don't jump off the building, yo, are you crazy? Okay, you got like wingsuits. This looks awesome. Okay, if vehicles can actually do that in game, get sucked into the hurricanes and all that. Oh, if they had it in VR, I would get scared a bit. Yeah, you'd get, like, sick playing this in VR. Look at that. What? Okay, that is awesome. Yeah, all I see is madness. Yeah, this is crazy, but in a really good way. Man. Okay, I'm super... so, 22nd, 2021. Not too far away. Okay, let's... I'm really excited to see that.
So, how was your
day?
Yeah,
exactly. This is what we wanted to see after playing Battlefield 4.
When is this, my birthday?
We're having a baby.
What's this?
You're under arrest for your father's murder 8 years ago.
What's going on?
Shut up! You know what this
12
is.
12 minutes.
You've been lying to me all this time?
I should never have told you.
I'm out of patience.
Yeah, Xbox is crushing it so far. I mean,
I've seen this a lot, but
and they still got more to go. They said like 30 games at the start of this, so I mean, we still got a long way to go. I get excited whenever Xbox Game Studios comes up because I know it could be Forza. This is obviously not Forza, but you know. Oh, this is,
the mind is the final frontier.
What is
of humanity.
It? I'm ready. This is the one they were showing out last time. I forget the name of it, but...
time for justice!
Is that Mozart or something?
is in your hands.
Psychonauts, that's it. You got it. Psychonauts 2, this has to be that.
The mission is falling apart. A psychonaut must always remember how to roll with it.
Yeah, it literally looks like a kid's, like an animated film. So, if gameplay's like this, it would be a pretty fun game. Dude, that is a sick
can
beard.
You do that?
Yes, if I can find some bacon.
I'm going to ignore that last part.
Get psyched. Looks like Crash Bandicoot. Yeah, I can see that. Bethesda, okay. Can we get some Doom
this
content?
This is usually the moment when I say hello and welcome to the Bethesda E3 showcase. We love that we can share the stage with Xbox this year, and whether you've known Bethesda for 35 years or are just getting to know us, we couldn't be happier to bring you the latest on your favorite games. We started this showcase with my good friend Todd Howard, who gave you a first look at Starfield. Along with Bethesda Game Studios, all of our teams are continuing to work on the projects that have been in development since well before we joined the Xbox family. So rest assured, the games you've been expecting and hoping for are still in the works. And today, we're bringing 10 more titles to Game Pass.
Awesome.
For a total of 30 Bethesda games.
No Horizon 5. We just started. We still got a long
like
way to
the
go.
The award-winning Doom Eternal. If you're looking for another reason to play it, Doom Eternal will be optimized for Xbox Series X and S on June 29th.
Nice.
Powered by id Tech, this next
I'm gonna hop back on Doom and play
free
this thing.
For everyone who owns Doom Eternal.
And I love Eternal.
X,
it's such
it
a good game. If you guys haven't played Doom Eternal,
play it. 60 FPS with ray tracing, a 4K mode, and an optional performance mode up to 120 FPS.
120 FPS. Let's go.
Or maybe you're in the mood for an RPG like Skyrim, which marks its 10th anniversary this November. We can't celebrate it without you, so share your favorite Skyrim memories, stories, artwork, and more on Skyrim10.com. Or explore an ever-changing post-apocalyptic wasteland.
What, they're not
going to
do
76.
Anything for
everything
Skyrim's
you love about
10th anniversary?
Custom
Forza
building,
has not showed up yet, so
storylines, warring factions,
don't
unique
worry
characters,
about Forza.
Places to discover, you'll find it all here. In fact, Fallout 76 is now
so
one
no
of
Forza
the most
yet.
Popular
still
games
wait.
On Game Pass, thanks to an incredibly welcoming and collaborative community. Here's a look at what's coming next in Fallout 76.
Man, I don't want to know what happens in Fallout. I mean, I did hear Fallout 76 got a lot better. It's in about an hour. I mean, we don't necessarily know how long it's going to be. They didn't say, at least from what I know. It's going to be a little while.
It came at a great cost.
Yeah, the 328 million DLC for Skyrim. Yeah, seriously. Or at least just like an updated version, optimized version for next gen console. Francisco, they're probably going to show Forza near closer to the end. We're not done the showcase yet, so I wouldn't say anything like that until we're actually done.
So it comes to this. I thought you understood what that insignia meant. You are no paladin of the Brotherhood.
Yeah, they're also showing a lot of Bethesda stuff right now, so this is the Xbox and Bethesda conference, so Bethesda's taking the stage right now. We'll get back to Xbox shortly. Yeah, exactly. Forza's gonna be close to the end of the stream. Maybe my boy posted up in the power armor.
I believe that we are now stronger than ever. This is a choice that can never be undone.
Any news on Starfield? Yes, Starfield was the first thing that was shown off. So once the stream is done, you can go back to the beginning of the stream. Starfield was the first thing that was shown off.
What the hell was that?
I think we got a release date too.
Expedition Squad Delta, report.
Wait,
over.
Did we? I don't know.
Squad Delta, what's going on?
I can't even remember.
Come on, this isn't funny.
Okay, so yeah, Star Wars my favorite space racing game. Exactly. That's how I look at it. Okay, so another expansion for Fallout 76. That's cool. I mean, I know there's a bunch of people that still play the game.
Wasteland isn't the only open world playground with an amazing community. The Elder Scrolls Online from ZeniMax Online Studios has now surpassed 18 million players.
No release date. Yeah, okay, that's what I thought. Signs of slowing down. I couldn't remember.
Right now, our players are enjoying the new Blackwood chapter, part of the Gates of Oblivion year-long adventure. We've got a lot more to come in ESO, including the conclusion to this epic story later this fall with ESO Deadlands. And with the release of ESO Console Enhanced this Tuesday, the game will deliver a true native experience optimized for the Series X and S.
Wait, is he not wearing any shoes, or is it just me? See, I never hopped into Elder Scrolls Online, but I always thought it looked interesting. I just prefer the single player of like Skyrim and Oblivion and all that. Forza Without a Horizon, amen, we don't know yet. So stay tuned. I have a feeling we're gonna see something, but we'll see. The Elder Scrolls Online. You're not gonna call it anything different? I mean, okay.
It's a
yes, exactly, Lone Koala. We do not want to see another Cyberpunk 2077, so let them take their time.
We'll take a new breed of fighter. Wait.
Oh yeah, no, it hasn't even been close to 30 games yet, so we still got a long way to go. Oh, this is definitely Forza Horizon. Oh yeah. This isn't even Horizon 5, bro. This is Horizon 6. This is what happens when you get emojis into Horizon 4. And when you have all the dance moves and all that, this is the next evolution of that. Horizon 5 on stage. This is what I'm saying, yo. This isn't even Horizon 5, though. This is Horizon 6. They skipped the game. Horizon on steroids? Yeah, dude, we got tentacles now. Horizon 6 Furry Edition. Yes, sir. That's exactly what we're looking for. Party Animals. No, wait. That was Horizon 6. Come on. They mistitled it. No, this is Horizon for PlayStation 7. Forza Horizon vs. Mario Kart Horizon. But Mario Kart's still good though.
Stupid boy. I told you.
Is this Hades? I never played Hades, but I heard really good things about the game. Francisco, we don't know yet. They're showing Bethesda stuff right now, so we just gotta wait till the end of the stream. Well, I'm sure we'll see something. Okay, another launch exclusive. What is this? Yo, look at that dog. Sheesh. No, this isn't Horizon 7. This is Gran Turismo 8. Yeah, can't wait to get rammed in turn 1 in 4K on Forza. Exactly. That's the Horizon multiplayer special. Gran Turismo open world, yeah, that's this. Oh no, it's GTA Horizon New Dawn Gran Turismo Horizon. Yeah, exactly. Exactly. So you guys are getting it now. Somerville. Another one with, 2022. Okay, cool.
This holiday Halo. Marks the okay, 20th let's see. Anniversary of Xbox and the 20th anniversary of Halo. To our millions of passionate fans, thank you.
We wouldn't be here without all of you.
Yeah, sequel to Need for Speed
our
The Run would be amazing. That was such a good game.
To bring players together. And for the first time, we're thrilled to offer our entire multiplayer experience to all players across Xbox and PC with no barriers. Halo Infinite Multiplayer will be free to play and invite more of you than ever before to become a Spartan
hero. I absolutely love this. Free multiplayer for everyone. You don't even have to own
the
game. I love this.
Halo Infinite. From helping craft the original Halo Combat Evolved, to leading the fan favorite, Halo 3 ODST, Joseph is a Halo visionary. It is so great to have him back with Halo.
Thank you, Bonnie. And hey, everybody. For us, and I hope many of you, Halo has always been about heroism and wonder, about fighting to keep humanity safe against impossible odds in a beautiful and mysterious sci-fi world. This is just one part of the Zeta Halo ring, the largest, most wide-open environment we've ever built, and we can't wait for you to explore it.
Yeah, the environment looks really good, actually. I'm really excited to see what the finished product looks like.
The heart of Halo is Spartan 117, the Master Chief. In the next chapter of the Chief's story, you'll face his greatest challenge yet, but you're not alone in the fight.
Oh, the main batteries are shut down. We're stuck out here.
Yeah, Halo 5's story was pretty meh, so I really hope that they took their time with this one and made it good.
It's enough.
So I see.
I need you to understand. There's not much time.
The Warthog was in Horizon, so this is Horizon 7. Hey, got you.
If you knew how you were going to die, you knew how you were going to die. How would you live your life differently?
Wait, did it just go through a wall?
What happened? Where is Cortana?
The rogue AI known as Cortana is gone. She's been deleted.
How? By you?
No, Cortana, bro, what is this?
Did you hit your head or something? Don't you remember? My instructions were to enter this installation, imitate Cortana, and lock her down for retrieval. Yours were to take her back to the Infinity for deletion. So if it wasn't you... Okay, then. There's something else. On successful deployment, my deletion routine was supposed to complete. Still here.
Good.
Good?
Something stopped your deletion. We need to find out why.
But this wasn't the mission.
The mission's changed.
And it's all you're so down they bad. Rule 34 about Cortana.
Are you sure? Bruh.
This man is down disastrous.
Of course, you can't have a Halo game without multiplayer. And on Xbox Series X, you'll be able to enjoy Infinite's multiplayer action at up to 120 frames per second. Finally, I'm very happy to announce that Halo Infinite's first free-to-play multiplayer season and Infinite's story-driven campaign will launch together this holiday.
Okay, so it's coming out this year. Awesome.
A new generation built to fight. Together, we are unstoppable. Are you ready?
Yeah, this actually does look really good, and the fact that the multiplayer is free for all. Yeah, I'm really happy with what Xbox is doing. Battle Pass as well. Yeah, it'll probably have a Battle Pass, but the game's the multiplayer is free anyways, so that's fine. Salty, that sucks, dude. Yeah, the GPU market is ridiculous right now, so hope you can get one soon, dude. Really good multiplayer, free to play. I'm so happy to see that, and the epic campaign. All right, holiday 2021, and it will be on Xbox One as well. Interesting. Super realistic. I mean, I don't know if I'd call it realistic, but looks good.
Evil has survived.
What is this?
A dark figure wanders in the east. He must be stopped.
Oh, I just hit my microphone. I'm really sorry if that was loud. What is this? Yeah, Xbox is insane this year. I'm really happy with what they're doing. Thought I got shot? Yeah, man. I literally hit my microphone with my phone. Yeah, I'm clever sometimes. I thought it was Resident Evil. Nah, Resident Evil 8 just came out, yo. Oh, so this is like an old game. I don't actually recognize it, so I don't know what game this is, but... looks pretty cool. Oh, Diablo 2 remastered or something like that. Resurrected, that's what they're calling it. Oh, nice. I know there's a lot of Diablo fans out there, so they'll be happy to see that, absolutely. That's going to be really good for them.
These things, where do they come from?
From all of us. From what we do to him.
Can you stop it?
I don't know. But he's my brother. And I would die for him.
What is this? What game is this, yo? This looks interesting. Think it's a war game? Something like that. A Plague Tale Requiem. Okay. I mean, I don't know anything about it, but that looks cool. Yeah, if you see captured in-game engine, you know it's going to be good. 4K, 60 FPS on Xbox Series X. Hey, Far Cry 6.
Hola, fascista.
I recognize that voice.
I'm super hyped for Far Cry 6.
Let me ask you a question. When I am dead and Yara is burning, what exactly is your plan? Hold hands, sing songs around the fire?
Sure, I know just the song.
Yeah, I'm so hyped for this game.
Time you learn about Resolver, Danny. To take down Castillo, a guerrilla needs the right tool for the right job.
Yeah, I think they took their time on this one, so I'm really hoping this turns out good.
It's a stealth operation?
Waiting for the downgrade. See, that's what I've noticed, is some of the character models and faces don't look that good in this game. So, I don't know what to expect for the release version.
Taking out a high,
I mean, it is a Ubisoft game,
I have just what you need.
Boom.
You wanna blow shit up?
Yes.
Juan Cortez at your service.
Okay, explosion looked good.
Who brought the rooster? Hey, whatever you need to get the job done, Danny.
Yo, you can have a pet rooster. Yes, okay, that's it. Find the game now.
Next time I see you, I want to play with that crazy backpack, dear.
Yeah, Salties are right there. It doesn't matter if the graphics are amazing, as long as the gameplay, the story, and all that are great. Exactly. Far Cry 3 and 4 was super fun. I like 5 too. 3, 4, 5. I really like those games. 5 gets a lot of slack, but actually, I quite like 5.
So do I.
Console launch exclusive. Playing The Crew 2 right now? Hell yeah, dude. Getting Spyro vibes. I mean, it's obviously not Spyro, but yeah, Stuart, I'm with you there. Actually, I actually really liked the Crew 1 over the Crew 2. Something about the atmosphere is just, it's really awesome. Slime Rancher. I mean, that's probably what it is. It's not my type of game, but... Slime Rancher. There you go. You got it. Oh, Slime Rancher 2. Okay. I mean, I never played the original, so... Crew 1 had a better story. Yeah, I mean, it wasn't great, but it was there.
Boom. Punch. Welcome back to Shreddageddon. Here's a new trick. Let's go.
Yeah, Crew 1 did have a lot of cop cars, but it was an expansion down the line, so... I mean, it's still cool nonetheless, right? So. Crew 2 has story. Crew 2 is like Horizon 4, man. There ain't really a story. The Tony Hawk band. I don't know if it's Tony Hawk. Could be. But Tony Hawk is a skater, right? Crew 2 has story? Oh, really? Okay, I don't remember it, so it mustn't have been that good. Steep? Yeah, that's what I'm thinking, steep. Something like that. Shredders. It looks like it could be fun if you're into that kind of game. What is the atomic heart? Whoa, that looks cool. This looks interesting. Whoa. Look at that. I don't know what this is, but I'm really liking the style of everything. Yeah, interesting music. I'm not turning the music down because I don't care if this gets copyright claimed. I want you guys to enjoy the music anyways. Death Stranding and Fallout mashup? Yo! That's pretty spot on, actually. That's kind of what it feels like. I don't know what this is, but this looks interesting, too. Definitely a lot of, like, retro vibes here. Hope they can get a Midnight Club game on Xbox. That would be at a Take-Two showcase or a Rockstar showcase, but yeah, I totally agree. A new Midnight Club game would be awesome. Hey, that's cool, Stuart. Thanks for coming to the stream. Replace. Okay. Looks like a cool little game. Game Pass, nice, nice. Xbox Game Studios presents Forza Horizon 5. This is not Forza Horizon 5.
In the first year of Grounded, millions of players.
Yeah, exactly, Francisco. It'll be close to the end once they get their filler stuff out the way. Most streams kind of, they have a big reveal at the start, and then they have a bunch of filler stuff that they gotta just fill the stream with in the middle, and then at the end you wanna have another big reveal, so. Forza will probably be closer to the end.
We present the Shroom and Doom update. It gives the people what they've been asking for. Like sitting. No, seriously, a lot of people wanna sit. For when you get sick of your human companions. And of course, mushrooms. But not those kinds. We've also got something that literally no one was asking for. The Brood Mother. She's so terrifying.
Damn, look at that. This is Grounded, right?
You should probably turn on arachnophobia mode.
Arachnophobia mode, okay. Even her blob scares
the sh out of us. Go big. Or never go home.
Grounded, yeah.
Oh, and it looks like we added achievements.
Grounded
too.
Looks pretty cool, actually.
Nice.
The Shroom and Doom update. Love it. No! This game's old now! This is pretty sus though, I'm not gonna lie. Dude, that music is so... that music's the meme of the death, I can't take it seriously anymore. Sussy Baka, exactly. Is this Among Us 2? Nah, bro, Among Us. No, this is the original Among Us. It just ain't even come out yet. Okay, what are they doing now? Don't know what this is. Does anybody play Among Us unironically anymore? I don't know. I never played it to begin with. Xbox is definitely sus, bro. Don't know what this is, but I'm sure some people will enjoy it.
Shown an aptitude for applying lethal solutions to conflicted
like
situations.
Cyberpunk 2077?
We wish to test your abilities.
I feel like we're going to enter a bit of a boring section of the showcase we're about right now. We're going to get pretty much nothing super interesting for a bit, but then when it gets to the end, we're gonna get some stuff picking up.
History is all around us.
What's this?
Those who made it have never been forgotten. Their daring choices echo across time, turning land
Cyberpunk
into
2078, hell yeah, dude.
And mortals into legends. If history was in your hands, what would you build?
Have you ever played Friday Night Funkin'? No, I have not actually. I don't know what that game is. Let me look that up real quick. Hey, we got my boy Useful Charts. That is my dad's channel, so if you are into that, go give him a check. Let me look up Friday Night Funkin' real quick. No, I've never even seen this before. Looks like a mobile game. Yeah, a little bit. Age of Empires 4. Okay, cool. Not my type of thing, but that's cool. Okay, a console exclusive.
We begin by hearing an old, wise-sounding voice. And we see a quiet, peaceful setting. This will make our game seem big and important. Now, something must break the serenity. Will this creature be in the game? No, say goodbye to it forever. Suddenly, and for no reason, people running. These pointless slow motion
shots, exactly, that's what this
make
is.
Everything seem cool and should bolster pre-sale numbers. That wah sound can mean only one thing. We must gaze over an epic shot of a world, and there should be lens flares. Now we see our hero. But only their silhouette, because the developers haven't finished the design, or finished the story, or finished any gameplay that's actually ready to show. In fact, the only thing they have finished is the title.
The Outer Worlds. Okay. Is this a... Oh! A sequel already? Damn, didn't the original just come out a few years ago? Outer Worlds 2, huh? Okay. Volume is still very low on desktop audio or my microphone. So this looks like a flight simulator. So I'll turn up the stream a bit. Okay, I turned up the stream a little bit. Let me know this is not Forza. Let me know if this is better in terms of volume. Yeah, this has to be. Yeah, this is flight sim. It's probably just the console version of flight sim. Yeah, we got Mount Fuji. Okay. A console. Nice. Oh, so we don't have to wait much longer for it on console. Awesome. Let me know in chat if the volume is still good or if it's too low. Another expansion. Nice. Awesome. Too high now. Okay. Let me turn it down a bit then. Just a little bit, so there we go. Let me know if this is better. Now, I don't want to get too excited here, but this looks like it could be Mexico. Oh my god, guys, let's go. This is it. This is it. Horizon 5, baby. Let's go. Yep, this is it. Horizon 5. Let's go. Oh my god, yes. This looks so good. Look at the weather effects. Yo. Oh my god. Evolution Star, your country is beautiful. Look at it. Look at it. Oh my god. Look at the graphics, guys. Wow, yo, this is going to be amazing. Yes! Yeah, November 9th this year. And it's on Xbox One, too. Xbox One. So you do not need an next-gen console.
Hello, I'm Mike Brown.
Yes, let's hear. Let's hear more. Games,
and I can't wait to show you what we've been working on.
Let's go.
Horizon is known for fun, freedom, and beauty. This year, the Horizon Festival arrives in beautiful, diverse Mexico.
Hello, Mexico.
This is the largest and most diverse open world ever in a Forza Horizon game. And there is no better car to explore it than the stunning AMG
Project One.
Rendered in unparalleled detail and with ray tracing in Forza Vista, thanks to the power of the Xbox Series consoles.
Oh my god.
I've invited along some of the team to help give you a taste of some of the amazing content that's waiting for you in Forza Horizon 5.
Okay.
Please welcome Bill, Maddie, Sierra, and Don from the Forza team.
Hey, Mike.
Hey, guys, what's up?
Hey, everyone.
Hey, what's up, Mike?
And we also have Abraham with us as well. He's one of the talented actors who will be appearing in the game.
Bienvenidos a Mexico.
Hey.
I can't wait to show you what we've been working on.
We begin in the rainforest on an expedition.
This nice.
Is a new campaign mode in which you set.
Look, I really like that tachometer. That looks really cool.
To explore new locations and discover places for the
graphics look amazing.
I'm on the river now. We're getting close.
There you are.
So the player has a voice this time. That's interesting.
I'm racing a car through the Mexican jungle, Rami. Doesn't get much better than this. I can see some ruins up ahead.
Syndicate one an Xbox now? Yeah, you're gonna need an Xbox or a PC if you want to play this.
That's a peek at our adventurous campaign. But Forza Horizon has always been a game that's best enjoyed with others. Let's go and see what some of our other players are up to. The Xbox Series consoles allow us to capture every last detail, right down to the individual needles on these Choya cactus. The scene
beautiful.
Looks real. but there are no tricks. This is in-game.
Maddie oh my
is
goodness.
The AMG Project One Forza Edition in Mexico's lush living desert. The perfect place to meet up with friends.
Guys, this is going to be such a fun game.
Thanks to the next generation of our Horizon Live servers, everyone else we see here are real players. And it looks
yep,
like
Francisco, this is Forza Horizon 5, dude. It came. Same Adam, I wasn't happy with Horizon 4, but I'm super hyped for this. Look at it! Look at it! Currently, the car we're watching is a Lamborghini Huracan. Oh, yo, look! Yo, did you see the 720? The roof was going up and down. The roof was going up and down on the 720, yo.
Just one of the many beautiful, faithful pieces of Mexico you'll find all over Forza Horizon 5.
Oh my god. Roof opening and closing confirmed.
Don drives down to the beach. We'll jump over to the Gran Caldera volcano. Check out this geology detail, implemented with precision accuracy using photogrammetry data captured on location atop an active Mexican volcano. The entire world has been recreated.
Unbelievable. Look at this.
And here's Sierra in her favorite off-road buggy. The volcano Sierra and friends are
I want to be an employee at Microsoft just to play this game. Looks like Horizon 3. Nah, man, this looks like Horizon 5. I don't know what you're talking about.
From up here, we can see for miles in every direction. In the distance, we can just about make out Guanajuato.
Look at that.
Guanajuato is one of the most beautiful cities anywhere in the world. It's a colorful, undulating city full of vibrant architecture. It even has a sprawling network of tunnels. And these twisting, turning, overlapping streets mean that as well as looking good, it plays great too. As we see here.
Okay, so we're gonna have the Battle Royale mode back again, but. Yeah, dude, I need a Series X now too. Oh my god.
The rest of our players are still out exploring this diverse open world. Let's head north to the canyon. The Horizon series is known for its uplifting beauty.
This looks incredible.
HDR camera rig, we captured 24-hour shoots of real Mexican skies at 12K resolution. And thanks to the Xbox Series consoles, these photorealistic skies result in lifelike lighting that dynamically changes every frame.
Does the Evo have a new body kit? It might. I personally didn't. I'm not sure, but.
Here's Maddie again.
Look at this.
She's joined by Abraham and some other members of the team. Our players are using Forza Link, the new AI assistant that intelligently tracks the status of you and the people you meet online.
Fast car, go fast. Hey, that kind of reminds me of the story in Horizon 4.
We'll now head deep into the rainforest and rejoin Bill and the rest of our players. Here we see our new volumetric lighting system filling the scene with god rays as the sunlight dapples through the dense rainforest. A Horizon arcade.
So the Forza, the Ford Broncos in the game. Let's go.
Bill loves minigames. So it intelligently prompts Sierra to invite Bill. Bill accepts, and they're seamlessly linked together with their GPS route set. With that Horizon Arcade minigame starting soon, all of our players are coming together. This minigame is called Piñata Pop, signaled by the Horizon cargo plane dropping a payload of piñatas.
Ooh, over this way. Gotta catch up to you guys.
This looks so good, dudes. Oh my god.
As many as they can.
Okay, go up here to the left.
There's loads along the main road.
Here I go.
I'll take a look through the bushes here.
There's some between the houses.
Oh, there's a couple more over here.
Sweet.
While the team grab those last few piñatas, we're going over to the stadium because I have one more thing to show you.
Okay, I'm a little concerned because they're showing all multiplayer stuff and we're not seeing anything single player, but still exciting nonetheless. I mean, it's very arcade, but, you know, we'll have to see until the game comes out.
Forza Horizon 5 is the largest, most fun, and most beautiful open world we've ever built. And it will truly be an astounding showcase for the Xbox Series consoles when it comes to Xbox Game Pass this November 9th. Thank you so much. I'll see you all in Mexico later this year.
All right, guys, that's it. GTA, this is not GTA 5, bruh. This is Horizon 5.
Team Xbox is on a mission
Phil Spencer.
Bring the joined community of gaming to everyone on the planet. That's why you, the gamer, are at the center of everything we do. Today, we showed you 30 games. 27 of them will be available on Xbox Game Pass. Now, through the end of the year, you can look forward to back-to-back monthly releases landing day one on Game Pass, led by 5 new titles from Xbox Game Studios, as well as highly anticipated games like Back for Blood, 12 Minutes, and The Ascent. And as we look ahead to next year, I'm inspired by the creativity of Bethesda and Xbox Game Studios. We showed you the highly anticipated RPG Starfield coming
Phil Spencer is sus.
Xbox. But we also have some of the industry's best RPG storytellers working on Avowed, Fable, The Elder Scrolls Online, Fallout 76, The Outer Worlds 2, and Elder Scrolls 6. We unveiled the stunning multiplayer mode for the world's most beloved shooter in Halo Infinite, adding to the roster of iconic Xbox shooters alongside Wolfenstein, Gears of War, Perfect Dark, and Doom. We premiered the most epic open-world racing game, Forza Horizon 5.
Dude, Horizon 5 is so
good. Bringing you a vibrant and authentic depiction of Mexico in a game built from the ground up for next gen. While the team at Turn 10...
Hey, don't be mentioning Black Panther Era 12. You got me too, bruh.
Our growing family of 23 studios is devoted to advancing the medium we all love. Xbox has been here for 20 years, and that's because of you. Our team strives to make Xbox a place where you'll find the greatest games, the most dedicated developers, and the most passionate community. Together, we all make Xbox the best place to play. Before I go, there's one more thing.
Motorsport 6 just showed. What are you
game from the
talking about? We just saw Horizon 5.
The studio that created Prey and Dishonored. Arkane created something new for them. An open-world immersive shooter that you can play alone or with your friends. And like Starfield, this game will be an Xbox exclusive.
Okay, another game. Midnight Club 5. Hey man, probably not gonna be on this stream. Deathloop? Could be Deathloop, but it said it's an Xbox exclusive.
So, that was fun, right?
That's your cue, mate!
Sleep tight.
This does look a lot like Deathloop. Is Deathloop suddenly now an Xbox exclusive?
They can't kill you anytime they want.
Hey, asshole.
Oh, Syndicate, what you're talking about with the Laguna Seca track? That wasn't Motorsport 6. That was the teaser for Forza Motorsport. For Forza 8, that they showed off last year. Nice frame drops. Yeah, I'm getting it too. It's been like that the whole stream. I think it's because of IGN's stream.
We are witnessing clear signs of cult activity as the locals engage.
This does look like Deathloop, right? Or am I just going crazy?
Thank you, Layla. You're the best. Oh, Jacob, don't even mention it.
Salty's Rockstar is not at E3 this year, so GTA 6 will not be showed. And it probably won't be showed until 2023.
Where's the other one? Where'd it go?
Give me a taste, bloodbag.
Bloody hell.
Taste this, cabrón!
Yeah, I mean, Francisco, I am a little concerned because it was showing a lot of the super arcadey game modes that Horizon 4 was starting, so I am a little concerned about that, but, I mean, the game's not out yet, so I don't want to make any judgments yet.
Sun's coming up. Let's keep moving.
Stuart, Horizon 5 showed off about 15 to 20 minutes ago. It looks incredible. But there's a lot of the arcadey gameplay of Horizon 4 back in there with the stadium and stuff like that. It's not to my taking, but the rest of the game, apart from that, looks incredible. Redfall. Okay, so this is not Deathloop. Interesting. Bite back. Alright, could be interesting. Yeah, go back about 20 minutes if you want to see Horizon 5. Okay, so it looks like we're just going to wrap off here. Stalker 2, this looks incredible. Horizon 5. Woo. Xbox knocked it out of the park. Like, seriously, they showed off. There's Horizon 5 for you, Stuart. They knocked it out of the park this time. Yeah, Stalker 2 and Horizon 5, those are good. So, real quick, for those watching the stream and interested in Horizon 5, I'm going to post another video today about Horizon 5. I'm going to go through and start analyzing the trailer and post another video. Yeah, exactly, Francisco. It's really awesome to see Horizon 5 in Mexico. Hey, Salties, that's fair enough, dude. A lot of people just love the gameplay in Horizon, and I totally respect that. You get a ton of cars and fun gameplay, and, you know, that's great. Thanks for watching. Woo! That was a good showcase. I'm going to turn the audio off now. Guys, that was a hell of a showcase. Man. This is great. Francisco sees his house in game. Yeah, dude. You can just go to your house in game. Guys, this was an absolute banger of a showcase. Oh, the Series X fridge. Yes, embrace the memes. Yes. Oh, I need one of these. Where can I get my Series X mini fridge? Yes. Yes. Embrace the memes, Xbox. Yes. Xbox and chill. Yo. Oh, Microsoft has a good, such a good advertising team, man. That's awesome. All right, so I'm going to end the stream pretty soon here. Thank you all so much for watching. This was really fun. First ever live stream on the channel, and I had a lot of fun. I really hope you guys enjoyed it too. So, yeah, I'm going to start working as soon as this is done on a video, kind of just analyzing the Horizon 5 trailer and seeing what we can see from it. And I'm going to plan to have that up later today. And I'm so hyped to see Horizon 5. So if you, Oh, thanks, Stuart. Really appreciate that, dude. Yeah, first stream. So I, you know, really new to streaming and all that. So I think I'm going to upload the live stream too. What I might do is I might edit out a little, you know, little bits and all that. But I am also, I think what I might do is I'll cut the Horizon 5 segment out and just upload my live reaction to Horizon 5 on the channel. So, yeah, stay tuned today. I'm probably going to have multiple videos up today, just as like a hype thing because of E3. So, thank you all so much for watching. And, yeah, stay tuned to the channel. See you guys later.